The key witness at the Seth Mazalia murder trial is on the stand today. Mazalia's former girlfriend, Kat McDonough, testified today. She was there the night that Lizzie Marriott was killed. McDonough shared details about how Mazalia killed the 19-year-old.
Ms. McDonough, who killed Elizabeth Marriott?
Seth Mazalia.
And how did Seth Mazalia kill Elizabeth Marriott? Please tell these jurors.
He strangled her with a rope.
After strangling Lizzie Marriott with a rope, did Seth Marriott have sex with her?
He did.
Did Ms. Marriott consent to that?
No.
How do you know what Seth Mazalia did to Elizabeth Marriott?
I was there.
Prosecutors continued to question McDonough on her relationship with Mazalia. She says the two met in 2011 at a theater performance in Portsmouth. When she was 17, Mazalia was 28. They kept in touch on Facebook, and the relationship eventually evolved into something sexual. McDonough also talked about how Seth pressured her to bring other women into their sexual encounters, in part to keep his temper in check. She described Seth as, quote, the dominant. She was, quote, the submissive. She also described a pattern of manipulation and how he did not want Kat talking with other men, putting her parents down, pressuring her to move in. Now, the defense says it was McDonough who murdered the UNH student during a sex game. McDonough is testifying today as part of a plea deal, and you can watch the entire Mazalia murder trial live right here on our website, WMUR.com. Well, residents in a Manchester neighborhood woke up this morning to a SWAT team outside their doors. The standoff happened on Dubuque Street in the west side of the city. It began with a fight at a convenience store and ended 7 hours later. Ray Brewer reports.
On Manchester's west side, some students passed by the SWAT team Tuesday morning as they were bused to class. The SWAT team was called after a man at 46 Dubuque Street, wanted by police, holed up in the second floor apartment.
I hadn't heard anything. I just was sleeping. Both my kids were sleeping, and then the police knocked on my door.
Michelle Steiner lives in the first floor apartment. She says it was around 1 o'clock in the morning when she got the knock at her door telling her she had to leave.
I did have to go out the back, yep, and the officers held the gun up to a window, walking backwards as me and my children were quickly evacuated up the alley.
In comes a police officer with a flashlight, and he says, we need to evacuate you. There's some dangerous men on the second floor.
Robin Sapersky lives on the third floor.
We just got up. We were in pajamas, everything, and he walked us out the back door with a lot of officers with guns in their hands.
The incident began, according to police, around midnight when 19-year-old Jacob Valley got in a fight. The other person called police and said that Valley might have a gun. Valley was located at Dubuque Street and taken into custody, but William Morier, seen here being taken into custody, refused to come out. That set in motion the standoff, with streets around the apartment blocked off. Then, around 7 o'clock, the SWAT team breached the apartment and Morier was arrested.
Now, police applied for a search warrant to see if they could locate a weapon inside the apartment. As for Morier, he's due in court tomorrow. New information in a deadly crash in Stratham. 61-year-old Leon Haas was riding his motorcycle on Portsmouth Avenue yesterday when he lost control and crashed into the back of an SUV that was stopped at a traffic light. Haas later died from his injuries. Officials say that no one else was hurt. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, one restaurant chain has promised to drop all additives from its food when it plans to make the change. And a new search effort is underway for Madeline McCann, where crews are now digging for clues. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.